And there's kind of this new setup, our new kind of level of existing, which is like the Google App Engine / Heroku model, which is completely managed. You don't even really think in the concept of machines. You just Google App Engine, you just upload your code. You don't think about OS. You don't think about anything. You just give it a wad of Python and they just run it. They run machines with the databases. They do the sharding. They do the replication. There's basically zero sysadmin, which is a great way to get started. And depending on how you like to work, on your technical sophistication, on the complexity of your website, you know, this may work fine. A lot of big websites have been built in the system. Udacity being one of them runs on Google App Engine. But it also means when you want to customize things, it's very difficult to do things that the providers of these services haven't thought of ahead of time for you. That's kind of the continuum of setups. There's no penalty for choosing wrong when you start because you can always switch between them. It's not always easy. When we switched from co-location to AWS, Reddit was a fairly large website at the time. So that was a little bit tricky. We had kind of two infrastructures, slowly migrated traffic from one to the other at a very high level. Actually, it worked okay. I'd suggest when you feel like you've outgrown Google App Engine or you want to do something that App Engine won't quite allow you to do, take a look at some of these other services and see if they get the job done right. And then maybe as you get really, really big, you hire dedicated system ins and maybe you want to have your own machines because it's a little bit cheaper and bandwidth requirements are higher than what Amazon can do, for example, or your storage requirements or data needs, you know, you need more. That's when you start thinking about having your own cage or having your own data center.